Okay, so I'm on the treadmill. One of my best ways of thinking that I've remarked about before is to go outside and run. But today, it's raining, so I thought, I'll just go on the treadmill. I'm just walking today, right now. I'll do my workout later. But you can get a lot of ideas flowing if the blood's flowing in your brain. You're just walking along at slow incline, and then I have my iPad Pro up here, but sometimes I have a deck where I put my laptop, and then I can just type away. And before you know it, you burned a ton of calories going at slow speed, but at incline. So anyway, my thought was, in mastermind groups, sometimes you'll get people who are at the top of their game, and for good reason, they've developed their talent, and then they've expended the money and resources to be there. And on the other hand, there's people who have the money to be there, but they don't yet have the talent, and that's okay. In general, though, they're not deluded about that. That's why they're there. But it gave me a thought about the Dunning-Kruger effect, which is to say, there's an effect where some people are so untalented or so unintelligent that they don't know, they don't have the mental resource to know how untalented they are. And I was thinking about different places I've been. I've been a runner in the past, and I've lived in Hollywood in the past, and there's a vast difference. As a runner, I was a two-time state champion runner in the mile and 2 mile. And there's no mistaking your place. It's time. You can't fool time. And so it's very hard to fool yourself, right? A person can't just show up to the state meet and go, why don't you let me run? There's levels to these things. It's very hard to delude yourself because the stopwatch is not going to allow it. There's electronic timing mechanisms now, but you get the idea. And in Hollywood, it was the reverse. There's no knowable mechanism, like a stopwatch, to know how good you are in relation to everybody else. But there are clear signs. Can you perform on camera? Can you memorize lines? Are you good looking? Do you fit the part? I wasn't there to be an actor. I was there to be an entrepreneur, to support people within that community. And I enjoyed it. But you'd see people who clearly had not done anything to develop any talent. They hadn't so much as turned on their webcam to practice being in front of a camera, let alone, having great presence, developing great presence on camera, etc. But there isn't really a knowable mechanism in Hollywood like there is in track or in basketball. You're going to know real quick if you step on the court whether you're good at that sport or not. It reminded me, the Dunning-Kruger effect really reminds me of the beginning of American Idol when that was a hit show. And they would do these auditions for where anybody could come in. And there'd be people who clearly could not sing and would just make a fool of themselves. And they would think that they should deserve to be on the show. Primarily, I think, just because they wanted to be famous. But they did make themselves famous in a way by getting on the show for being so bad and thinking that they're so good. There's such a dichotomy between what they think they are and what they are. And to be successful, those two things have to match. Your mindset and your talent need to match, and then you can rise up. Anyway, that's the 2 pages or more I'm writing for the book today. How certain people just don't either have the talent or aren't willing to create the talent to be good as an entrepreneur. There's many things that you need to be good as an entrepreneur, and some people don't do any of them. So, that's what I'm writing today. And I essentially said the piece I'm writing. I'm going to put it into one of the mastermind groups that I'm thinking about in particular, where everybody's considered an expert, and I hate that thought process because there'd be people with no talent, and then the person would just say you're all the best in the world at what you do, and I think this guy isn't even the best. Like, if you walk down the street, you could hit people with a rock and be better than this person. And so that would irk me, that mentality of just say that they're great. And I don't know. But I want to put that in the book because I feel like there's been an overabundance of telling people that they're experts. Just because they read a book, this person read a book, this person didn't, so this person teaches this person, is the mentality. And I feel like, is the mentality to brand yourself an expert. And I feel like that's so silly. Anyway, I'm gonna continue on.